Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Okami. It is me, Ralphie93, and for our fourth episode, we are still in Waku Shrine. In the last episode, we defeated, kind of, Nechku, the silver demon of Ezofuji, with the help of Shiranui. Yeah, he appeared. Not doing so well now, though, so that's kind of sad. But hopefully we can defeat... We can truly defeat the two demons. Oh my gosh, perfect wind skills. That's where I wanted that to go. But hopefully we can defeat the demons as a sort of vengeance for him. Alright, oh my gosh, ball, where are you going? Ball. Okay, we need the ball in here because we got all these super fast spinny fire wheels. So we're gonna need this ball as a starter to make some into ice, as an ice source. So let's freeze all of them, nearly. Good, good. And, oh, there's a treasure chest over there. Okay, let's go to that treasure chest first. I wonder if we can freeze. No, we can't freeze treasure chests in order to remove the flame. So that's fine, whatever. I don't actually know what's in this chest. Something good, hopefully. If I can blow it away. No, no, no. I want some of you to stay ice, please. There we go. Well, smash that. Ooh. Emerald tassels. That's a pretty... I love the tassel... treasure family, if you will. They're super pretty looking. And I'm a thing for prettiness. I like pretty colors, mind you. I myself am not like a jewelry wearer, but I do love the colors. I'm a fan of color. Especially in like PowerPoint presentations. Oh my god, it fell! But we're making like PowerPoint presentations for my one class, and like one of the things are like how to actually make proper presentations. So things like font size, font type, you know, things that we like, don't like use of color. And I always personally, like, even if it's, I find it's easiest to read black text on a white background. However, I do want there to be some color in the slides. Otherwise, it's just like, oh, this is boring. Whether it just be like a little thin border around the outside or pictures. I love pictures in my PowerPoint slides. I'm also more of a fan of slides that tend to have as little information as possible on them and then people talk about them. I don't know, that's just me. That's how I like to make them, and that's how I like to be taught by them. What did I blow up? A key. A key, yes. So I have been working on a PowerPoint presentation that is follows that criteria. So, due to be presented in a few days. So that's kind of nice, I guess. Ooh, I thought I almost fell off. Oop, no. Don't be wiggling. Stay frozen. And don't fall off. Oh my gosh, that was close. Alright, so we got the key, we got the treasure chest, let's book it through here. Oh, this is another one of these guys! Blech. Oh, sorry, premature blood. Blech. I'm sure it's the noise they would make if they could. Alright! So here we are. Golden Gate. Oki's on the other side there, but maybe the merchant. It's an it merchant, I thought that white was his beard. Who goes there? Hey, how'd you get in here? You ain't come to invade us poor folk of Aku Shrine, have ya? If you have, you got me to answer to. A fight to end all fights. The best way to settle it? With a bit of business, of course. Do some shopping? Yeah, let's do some shopping. Can we buy... Oh, I thought maybe we could buy our Trinity mirror that we don't have, but we can't. Not here. We can sell. Let's sell all of our tassels. Cool. Thank you, sir. Alright, so let's save, because there's a golden gate and a save mirror. There's a boss fight coming up. Yeah, I think this is like... I would say this is one of the few dungeons I've ever played where there's truly two boss fights. I guess you could count the fight with Nechku alone as a mini boss, but I don't know. He's a part of the boss, so. Okay. How'd you get here so quick? Yeah, how did you get here quick? Actually, I owe it to that wolf and his little friend. A poggle appeared after you left and told me to go help Amaterasu. So that was the wolf's companion you were talking about, right? That wolf really seemed to perk up when the Ponko appeared. It looked like the wolf had recovered somewhat. I sensed they had a bond that made me feel they'd be okay. So I left them and came rushing here. But enough talk for now. I take it that if you're here, those demons must be somewhere up ahead. Well, Amaterasu, will you fight alongside me? Fight together with Oki? Let's rumble! O spirits of the air, earth, and sea, grant us your divine power. A That's so scary. So this is where those bird brains went. They're trying to hide while they lick their wounds. We can't let those infernal contraptions get away this time. And I don't think we have enough energy to chase them down again. Them? Get away again? No prey has ever eluded my trusty Denkomaru more than once. Nor my own. I don't have any glowy eyes powers, but okay. Alright, Lechku and Nechku! Let's get this started. So basically, they pull things out of their hats. Deflect them to the best of your abilities. That's what I've seen does seem to work the best. Again, I do have difficulties with these bosses, but that definitely seems to work. Well, what is that guy doing? You are creating a bomb of some kind. Power slash that. To get that down. And you can't really attack them. They are pervious to attacks until they actually produce something. What are you? You're blooming. Let's bloom that ourselves. You just basically have to work with what they're going. It's a battle at their own pace, if you will. Just basically keep them both in sight. Oh, he pulled out Ninetales sword. That's interesting. He can shock that. Okay, he's stunned. Oki will come running to you. Bite his arrow that he produces of ice. Now, Amaterasu, pull me back like an arrow and fire me at those demons. I will pull them down to the ground. Bite it and let go, and that will bring it down to the ground. Kind of, maybe. Come on, fall down, you bug. I'm not keeping your other one, your other half, intact. Oki, are you not going to bring it down? How am I supposed to attack it? There he is. Eventually he will, and that's your opportunity to attack it. Can we power slash it at all? Ooh, we can. That works well. Alright, so what's Nechku up to? He has a bomb. I don't know what to do with that. Power slash it? Just avoid it! Nope! Out of the way. It's hard to tell who has the icicles, if it's Oki doing it or if it's the demons doing it. But this is kind of an interesting fight, but yeah, I kind of don't like it how it's at their pace. Can I get both of those? I did. Sweet. Let's smash that. Oki should come running. See? Oh, what are we aiming for? Both of them are stunned, but while that one's stunned, I guess we can take this other guy down. Yeah, can I shock him? Nothing, really. Unfortunately, can I power slash him? No. You have to definitely let Oki bring them down when they're stunned. Oh, he's letting me do it again. There we go. So, are you going to actually get him? Oki, bring him down? You didn't do the other one. Oh, perfect. Power slash it. That seems to do the most damage, although it seems that once you power slash him, it's done for. So perhaps an idea that I'm coming up as I'm just going through with this is to... Oh! No, don't touch me! Don't touch me! Please don't touch me! I guess with that, maybe I should use Veil of Mist. That will probably... What are you doing? No! None of that! Yeah, Veil of Mist to avoid those. For sure. Alright, what are you doing over there, you? What have you produced? You produced a bud. Oops, not that. I wanted to bloom it. Perfect! And it gives me life. Is that Oki's or is that Lechku's? Looks like Lechku's. Okay, get your ass over here! And release! Fantastic. Alright. So yeah, maybe a few hits with the glaive, your weapon first, and then power slash? Oh, he's still down. Interesting. Alright, and power slash again. Alright, that did quite a bit of damage. That's good. We're doing well so far. Considering I really don't know what I'm doing. Alright, they're both getting stuff out of their hat. Can I blow that up? Nope. No, I cannot. Let's power slash that, though. I'm not entirely sure what those kind of pods do. Oh, sorry. I did not realize I had stunned him. Alright, come on. Let's go get him. Bring him down to the ground. Oh. Lechku, what are you doing that close to me? Or Nechku, I keep getting their names confused. No. Dude, get away. I didn't mean to shock him. Whoa. Ha ha. Ha 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 ha. So many balls. I don't know, did I get it? Loki, or Loki. Okay, not Loki. That is a Greek god. Alright, make sure other doofus is out of my sight. Or is in my sight. Oh my gosh, I thought I saw somebody flying towards me. Oh no, he's way over there. Okay, bring him down. Okay, it's your job to bring him down, and you didn't. Can I power slash him? Oh, that brought him down. Okay, that's good to know. I'm just gonna veil a time, or veil a mist while he's down, just in case the other one decides to attack me at all. Alright, seems to work. What are you doing, man? Whoa. I don't want to look at that one. I want to look at the other one. Because he's doing stuff with his sword. Okay, Oki. Come to me. Release him. You can take this guy down. Sure we can. Yeah, okay, power slash him when Oki's on him, and that seems to work. I wasn't aware of that. Nope, no. Don't come after me. I don't exist. I'm not here. Nope. Oh my god, you got me! No! Release me! Oh, okay. Not so bad. Yeah, they will pick you up with their talons. And that's never good. Alright, what are you doing for me? A bloom. That doesn't really help me destroy you, but it'll help me get some life, I suppose. Yeah, life! Alright, I don't know what to do with that one. Oh, can I light it on fire? There we go! You can light it on fire! I didn't know that. Learning stuff every day makes you smarter. Or possibly good at the video games. Alright, this guy's done. Alright, that wasn't so bad. Because yeah, basically counterattack everything they give you. Like, you do have, like, lightning and blizzard and fire. Fire wasn't utilizing for those bombs, but... yeah, you can pretty much... and then power slash them with Oki on them so that you actually get them down. Good to know. Way to go, Oki. We did well. Between demons, which had suddenly awoken atop Ezofuji, and tried to lay waste to the land of Kamui, were defeated. They disappeared in a burst of petals, thanks to Oki and Amaterasu. However, a giant cloud, black as night, cast a shadow on the scene. Blight, Ninetales, the twin demons Lechku and Nechku. The souls of each were swept into the cloud as it moved. It drifted toward the Ark of Yamato at the bottom of Laochi Lake. The Ark of Yamato is beckoning all the world's darkness within. Tuskel's words echoed ominously, awakening Amaterasu's heart. All the sacrifices, all the life lost in the name of good. Was it all in vain? Shiranui, Amaterasu's 100-year-old incarnation, was fatigued and exhausted by the intense battle. However, when Shiranui noticed the glow of Oki's sword, Kutone, a sly smile seemed to crease the wolf's tired lips. Satisfied with this bright glimmer of hope, Shiranui struggled to rise and put every last ounce of strength into passing through Ishaku's gate, back in time, back home. As Amaterasu and Isun looked on, they were fully aware that Shiranui headed back into the face of danger, to the battle with Orochi. After saving Nagi from the clutches of death and aiding them in their own quest, Shiranui would die a hero, marking the beginning of the legend of Orochi. As Ishaku left the scene, his eyes betrayed the sort of toughness one exhibits when preparing for a grave event. You obtained Sun Fragment. You collected 3 Sun Fragments to form a unit of solar energy, the 20th piece we can have. Alright, time wasn't too bad. It was definitely better than when I practiced. Would you like to save the game? Of course, game. Thank you for asking. There. Amaterasu and the others returned to the foot of Ezofuji. There they saw Lika, praying intently. The storm had subsided. Then, as if to celebrate their hard-won victory, the twin volcanoes of Ezofuji erupted in great pillars of flame. The villagers felt the warmth on their skin and wept tears of joy. However, Oki merely surveyed the scene stoically, remaining silent. Although the evil demons had been driven away, the thought of having taken the sword and caused so much grief weighed heavily on his heart. The only one who could ease the burden of his woes was Semiko. The chieftain who had rescued Kimu from the shrine stepped forward. Silently, he approached Oki, offering an outstretched hand. His eyes betrayed the complexity of the emotions behind the gesture. Oki, realizing the gravity of the scene, extended his hand in turn. The moment they shook hands, Wapkir was reborn into a village far too strong to ever fall victim to evil again. As for Kratoni, the sword that vanquished the twin demons, it was returned to its pedestal by Oki's own hands. And as long as the glow remained, no evil dared draw close. Kratoni's gleam spoke of a power too great to succumb to evil. At that moment, a brilliant flash of light shot forth from Kratoni, striking squarely on the frozen surface of the Ochi Lake. Though the lake had never shown any sign of melting, cracks began to open up along its surface. The legend of the Iron Ark, Yamato, said to have fallen from heaven, and the holy Lochi Lake, which it called home, was revealed to be more than a mere legend before all those present. The Ark of Yamato is floating in the sky. How can such an enormous thing float into the sky like that? It must mean what the old legend says is true. Legend about how this Ark, which was sunk in Lochi Lake, fell from the celestial plane into our world. It says the Celestials who fell to our world with it were eaten up by countless vicious monsters. By the army controlled by the evil ruler of darkness, Yami. So the Ark of Yamato is related to the powers of darkness. Tuskel, I'm scared! Oh, we'll be fine, Lika. You're alright. The Ark of Yamato. They say it fell from the heavens. It is indeed imposing. The wall of ice shall shatter and open the way to the heavens when Kratoni glows silver. The prophecy's wall of ice is not the demon's blizzard. Rather, it is the ice in our own perpetually frozen lake. Amaterasu, if that Ark is the way to the heavens, then you must embark upon it. Though we have not known each other long, I can already tell what sort of being you are. For you, the realm of the gods lies ahead. It is a journey the rest of us cannot take. You knew that, didn't you, Amaterasu? Maybe. Alright, so, here's the deal. That right there, that is the end of our game. If we go up there. However, there's still stray beads we need to collect. I want to get that Trinity Mirror so we can complete our reflectors and such. For the next few episodes, we'll be backtracking, beginning the remaining stray beads that we have yet to get, doing the Demon Gate trials before we embark on the arc of Mato. So I'm sorry, Lilika, if you're scared, you're gonna have to be scared for a little while longer while I go do those things. So I thank you guys for watching this episode of Okami, and I will see you in the next one.